too much salt? Well, let's get into it. So in order to make our crispy fish tacos, we're going to need a few ingredients. Be sure to look down here and make sure that you follow along with the ingredients list. That way you can make this master creation with me. So some of the first ingredients you're going to need, of course, is fish. You can utilize any kind of white fish that you like, cod, halibut, tilapia, whichever you like to utilize. Today I have some tilapia, and I'm only making one serving, so I'm only using one fish, and you might even make two or three tacos with just one fish. So you have tilapia, that's your first thing. Then of course you're going to need some corn tortillas. I chose the white corn tortillas. You can utilize the yellow corn tortillas or even flour tortillas if that's what you're into. Trust me with the corn ones because they're a lot healthier for you. For our fish, we're going to want to season it with some good flavor, right? Because food has to taste delicious, right? So we're going to utilize a few different ingredients here. So to give our fish some good flavor, we're going to utilize Mrs. Dash salt-free Caribbean citrus seasoning because we want to bring some island delicious flavors into our fish. We're going to also utilize some onion powder. We're going to use some garlic powder. We're going to use this thing called True Lime. I don't even know if you know about this yet, but True Lime is really delicious. It's made from crystallized lime, and they mix it with garlic and cilantro in it too, and it's pretty good seasoning to have. It tastes good in rice and other things. Make sure you hit that like button if you want to know more about this True Lime seasoning. We're going to also utilize some coriander just for a little bit of extra flavor. We're going to have some ground black pepper, and if you've been watching out there, you know what's coming up next. Pink Himalayan sea salt, because we like our things a little bit salty, not too salty. We'll get more into the salt factor later. And we're making crispy fish, right? So we're going to need some breadcrumbs. Now I have two kinds of breadcrumbs that I'm going to be utilizing today, but you don't have to use the two. I like using some panko breadcrumbs because they make things a little bit extra crispy, but also regular breadcrumbs are perfectly fine. I get the seasoned kind so that I don't have to do too much work with my breadcrumbs to make sure they're well seasoned. You're going to also need some extra virgin olive oil, just a little bit. And those are the things we're going to need to season our fish and make sure that it's really tasty. We're going to have some things that we want to put on top of our fish, right? So we're going to make a cilantro crema sauce, and we're going to utilize some cilantro that I have here. We're going to utilize lime, garlic, cloves. I like two. You can use as much or as little garlic as you want. We're going to use some jalapeno pepper. We're also going to utilize some Greek yogurt, and we're going to also put some salsa on top of our fish tacos. I like the medium, spicy, or hot salsa, but if you're more of a mild person, utilize mild salsa. And we're going to also top it with some shredded cabbage because fish tacos taste good with a little bit of a crunch. And I like to get the one that's already pre-prepared. You might see it in your Publix or Winn-Dixie or Walmart, or wherever you're going to get your groceries, as coleslaw. So you can utilize the coleslaw package and utilize it for your fish. And of course, you're going to need a few tools to utilize. I have over here one of my favorite tools of the kitchen, and it is a small mini food processor. So if you have a food processor, we're going to be utilizing that today. And also an air fryer, because we want crispy fish tacos, right? And we don't want to fry it because we're all about the health here. So we're going to put it in our air fryer to make it nice and crispy. So now that we know what we need to make our crispy fish tacos, let's get cooking. All right, so we're going to start by getting our fish nice and seasoned and prepared to go into our air fryer over here. So we need a knife, and we're going to cut our fish down the middle, because we want to make bite-sized pieces so that it could go into our taco. So we're going to cut it in half. We're going to cut this in half, down the middle, and then we're just going to make pieces. So we're going to just cut it along and make some bite-sized pieces. getting our fish prepared so that we could put it in our bowl and get it nice and seasoned. And like I said, when we were going down the ingredients list, this could probably make 2 to 3 tacos. I'm only gonna have one today, just me today. Hubby's not really a fish person, so I get to eat all the good stuff. Alright, so now that we have cut our fish into our portions and slices, gonna get that last piece cut and put into our bowl here. So we have all of our fish nice and cut up. Move that to the side. And we're gonna go into now our seasoning. The first seasoning we're gonna go into is our Caribbean citrus, because remember we wanna bring citrus flavors to our fish. So we're gonna be pretty generous with this one. And in this, if you wanna know, it has great things like sweet pepper, sweet chili pepper, thyme, black pepper, allspice, nutmeg, cayenne pepper, ginger, cinnamon, parsley, basil. It has so many delicious seasonings and citruses too, as orange peel, lime juice solids, just different things that's really good. So it allows a lot of citrus flavors to get into the fish. So we put a good amount of that in there. We're gonna next hit it with some of our lime seasoning. So, cause we want more citrus in this. We want nice citrus pop. We want brightness to come out in our food. So we put a good amount of the lime. We're gonna next go in with our garlic powder. And we're gonna give that a good amount. Cause we like garlic. It may make your breath stink, but it tastes so good. And we're gonna next go in with our onion powder, and we just need a little bit of that, not too much. Next, coriander. It already has some coriander in there, and we're just adding just a little bit more. So just a little bit more coriander. And then last, not last, because we still have to add our pink Himalayan sea salt, but second to last is our black pepper. And we just want a good amount of that. Not too much, because we don't want it to be overpowering, but just enough to give it a little kick, right? We want a little bit of that. And of course, we need our pink Himalayan sea salt. It would not be delicious fish tacos if we don't have a little salt into this. So we're adding a little bit of pink Himalayan sea salt in there. And we want to add about a capful of our olive oil. So we measure our capful and we want to drizzle it over our fish. So we have to incorporate all of our seasonings together. So we want to give that a nice stir. And you could prepare this the night before and let it sit overnight so that the seasonings can get really into your fish. And then prepare it for when you're ready to eat it. So we're gonna place that aside for right now, and we're gonna go into our breadcrumbs. So, like I said earlier, I like to utilize panko breadcrumbs too, because it adds a little bit of extra crunch. So I'm gonna put probably about half of a cup, which is the rest of my breadcrumbs, about half of a cup of breadcrumbs, and then maybe 1/4 of a cup of panko, and I have about 1/4 in here. We have that, and we want to give them a little toss around to incorporate the breadcrumbs and the panko together. You could stir it also with a spoon. And then I'm going to come back in here with our fish. So our fish already has olive oil on it so that it's nice and prepared so that we can dip it into our breadcrumbs. So I'm gonna actually open up my air fryer, get this set right here, so that when I finish dipping my fish into my breadcrumbs, I could place it right into our air fryer. So we dip our breadcrumbs, and it doesn't need to be super coated. We just want a nice crunch on the outside, and then we go into our air fryer. We You're just gonna keep doing that with all the pieces, making sure each piece gets nice and good coating. Doesn't need to be drenched in it. We're not deep frying this, so it doesn't need to be super drenched. It just needs a nice coating, just have a crisp crunch on the outside. Everyone out there is doing well today and is excited about making this delicious meal with me and trying and giving it to their families, because it's a really great meal, especially during the summer, to have. This fish tends to be better in the summer, more fish is plentiful in the summer, and besides, my husband, who doesn't like a good fish taco? Reminds you of the sea and ocean and being on the beach, which is nice. So I remember when we're using our air fryer, we don't want to overcrowd our air fryer because we want the air to circulate. So I'm going to put about maybe two more pieces in here so that we're not overcrowded. Over to our air fryer, and we're going to turn our air fryer on to about 350 degrees, and we want to do it for about 15 minutes, and we set it and we wait. So while we wait for that, we'll get ready to make our cilantro crema. Now that we have our fish in our air fryer, we're going to start by making our cilantro crema. So for our cilantro crema, we're going to need some Greek yogurt, lemon or lime, some cilantro, some avocado, some garlic, and also jalapeno pepper. I'm gonna start with my jalapeno pepper, and I'm gonna cut just a piece off of it because I don't need the whole jalapeno. I don't want it very spicy. So I'm gonna place this other part of the jalapeno just to the side, and I'm gonna take my little piece that I cut and cut that in half and place that at the bottom of my it's so funny, I just forgot what this is called, but it is my mini food processor. So I have my mini food processor here. I put my my serrano pepper, I can't talk today apparently, my serrano pepper into my food processor, and I'm going to take about 2 tablespoons of my Greek yogurt. And I love Greek yogurt because it's so versatile. You can utilize it on everything. It tastes, if you use it on tacos, it tastes just like sour cream. You won't even know the difference. Most of the time, I don't even tell my friends that I'm utilizing Greek yogurt. Don't tell them that I told you that. Let's be our little secret, okay? So we have our Greek yogurt in our food processor. We're gonna squeeze our lemon into there as well. It's okay if the seeds fall in, we'll just pick them out. Pick those seeds out. And then we're gonna take our avocado, and we're using a half of an avocado here. And I'm just making some slices across it so that it's easier to take out. Drop in our 2 cloves of garlic in there, and we're going to take a nice big bunch of cilantro and also drop that in there. Do a little bit more with my lemon. We mix it all together. Nice and tight, and give it a pulse. And I say start with a few pulses before you start blending completely. Because you want to incorporate it together. And as you can see, it's starting to combine, so you can let it go for a little while. Blended up a little bit of our cilantro crema, and we want to add a little bit of water to loosen it up a little bit. So I have maybe about a tablespoon of water. So we want to add that in there. And we're going to also add in our salt and pepper to season it. So a little bit of the sea salt, pink Himalayan, of course, and some pepper. Give it a few more pulses. You can taste the garlic, you can taste the cilantro. You'll probably want to add a little dash of salt more and some more water to loosen it up. But otherwise, it's pretty good to go. So our air fryer is finished cooking our crispy fish. Let's take it out. So we want to remove it. And there you have it. Nice crispy fish. You can kind of hear the crispiness. So we have two corn tortillas here. And I like to use two because it makes it a little bit easier to hold together. And we got some substance to put on here, so we don't want our taco falling apart. So we're gonna go ahead and place some of our fish down. We're gonna start by putting it in the middle of our taco. Depending on the sizes of your fish, you might get 4 to 5. I have about 4 here. 4 pieces. So we have that there. So as you can see, crispy fish on our taco. And now we're gonna start putting some of our toppings on. So I like to first and go ahead and put some cheese down, if you like cheese. I put some fat-free cheddar first so that it could melt on top of our fish because our fish is nice and hot and ready to go. So I put about half a tablespoon of cheese first. And then I will go in and put some of my cabbage on top of there. More crunch on top of our taco. And then I like a little bit of avocado, so I'm gonna put a little bit of avocado. And remember, we're building color. You know, I'm all about color here on Faith in Food. We want to have colorful, delicious looking meals because we eat with our eyes and we want our eyes to be pleased with what we're eating. So I'm adding greens, gonna add a little bit of red. I have purple from the cabbage. I got yellow from my cheese. So next in, I'm gonna put a little bit more cilantro because I love the taste of cilantro. It brings a lot of great flavor into the food. So I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of cilantro on top of there. Then I'm gonna go ahead with my salsa. And I'm just gonna add a little bit of this salsa into there. And you could, of course, utilize fresh homemade salsa. I could show you guys if you'd like and hit that like button for a fresh homemade salsa. I have a few different kinds, some fruit salsas too. So we have a little bit of our salsa in there. back to the side. And last but not least, we're gonna go ahead and utilize our cilantro crema that we made. So we're gonna just give it a nice little drizzle on top of our taco. And you can be as generous or as little as you want with this. It's not spicy, it adds good flavor, and brings beautiful color to our taco. And there we have it. Our crispy, delicious fish tacos. And there we have it, our master creation of crispy fish tacos with a cilantro crema sauce. Well, we have to take a bite of it to know how good it is, right? So let's take our one bite. So I'm super excited about this because I love fish tacos and all of these delicious flavors are marinated together. And I can see my cheese has melted on there. It's gonna be a really good bite. Everything. The layers of flavor in this are outstanding. The fish is crispy, the cheese is melting, you have cilantro flavors, you have a little bit of citrus for that pop. That is one good fish taco. That one bite was absolutely delicious. And now I have a little food for thought for you for today. Remember in the beginning I said we were going to talk about too much salt? Well, in today's society, they want you to have way too much sauce, right? But as Christians, it wouldn't be good to have too much salt. My scripture reference is Matthew 5:13, where it says, "You are the salt of the earth. But what good is salt if it has no more flavor, or if it loses its saltiness? Can you make it salty again? No. It's good for nothing but to be thrown up and trampled over by men." So that's the same thing with Christians, right? We could be really salty and sprinkle a little bit of our salt, which is God's love, God's word, the things that he has instilled in us, to our friends, our family, and show them the light of Christ, right? Because this scripture also talks about being the light of the world. But if you're too salty, then you're no good anymore as that Christian. You can't show God's love and God's grace and his mercies to everyone else because you can't even connect with the people that you're with because you got too much salt. So my question for you today is, are you too salty or are you having the right amount of salt sprinkled over the earth? Thanks for tuning in to this week's episode of Faith in Food. If you liked what you're seeing, do me a favor and share this with two or three or all of your friends. And be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Oh yeah! Don't forget to hit your notification bell because you don't want to miss a wonderful new episode of Faith in Food. And did I mention to subscribe? That one is super important because you don't want to miss this beautiful train and journey that we're going on Faith in Food. And remember, your food doesn't have to be boring and neither does your faith. So whatever you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it unto the glory of God. I'll see you next week on Faith in Food.